Hi friends, welcome to Erotic Solutions. Let's see the application with microcontroller. I just want interface DC motor with 8051 microcontroller. Before proceeding interfacing with DC motor, so you should understand how DC motors are works and what way they are available from the market and where they are using these DC motors in applications. So DC motors have standard characteristics. Whenever you are trying to work with DC motors, they are available with different characteristics from the market. Any motor you are trying to buy, so this is a simple outlook of DC motor which comes with two standard leads, plus and minus. So if you are giving positive supply for this, which means the required VCC across plus lead and ground connection across negative lead, the DC motor starts clockwise rotation. The same DC motor which is rotating anti-clockwise just by changing the source polarities. The plus lead is connected to ground and negative lead is connected with VCC, so that the reaction from the DC motor is which allows to rotate anti-clockwise. So any DC motor, which may be 12 volts DC motor, it may be 5 volts DC motor, so it may be 3.5 volt DC motor, any motor you are taking, so this is a simple behavior. So you need to provide the positive supply across plus and minus with ground, so the reaction from the DC motor is clockwise rotation. So if you are changing your source polarities, your DC motor rotates anti-clockwise. Now, so the DC motors are available with standard characteristics. So characteristics means you need to specify what is the voltage rating of DC motor. So with how much voltage it is going to operate, whether it is a 5 volts DC motor or 12 volts DC motor or 24 volts DC motor. Even these DC motors are used in railway engines, which are locomotives. So the applications, areas of applications is automobiles, printers, robotics, and industry conveyor belts. And there are many applications they are using these DC motors, but it may be different voltage characteristics. Even for simple cooling fans, so these DC motors which are used for different kinds of applications. So remember, your DC motor is available with different voltage rating, and also you need to focus on current rating of your DC motor. Means how much sufficient current required to drive your DC motor. And also the another important parameter you need to know about DC motors is RPM, which is rotations per minute. So this RPM, which is considered whenever you are looking for speed control operations in a regular way, because there is a small DC motor which may works with different RPMs, which may be 1000 RPM, 100 RPM, 60 RPM, 10 RPM, 40 RPM. So these are the different rotations per minute you may find from DC motors. Even though everything is DC motor, but you should concentrate on the three important characteristics: voltage, what is the sufficient voltage it requires to run, and how much current it is going to use, and how much of RPM. So without knowing these three characteristics, you cannot control your DC motors in a proper way. But every DC motor, maybe it is a 5 volts DC motor, it comes with two leads, it may be 24 volts, it may be 100 volts, it may be 1000 volts, irrespective of any voltage, your DC motors are available with two standard leads. Again, there are different categories of DC motors, which are brushless DC motors or coupled DC motors. There are many types, but any kind of DC motor come up with this two standard leads. Okay, so with microcontrollers, whenever you are trying to control these kind of DC motors, so you need to do in between controllers and motors. So the selection is very important. You need to know for these characteristics. Without knowing these characteristics, you cannot proceed interfacing with DC motors. That is the only reason, because the switching device, your microcontrollers are working with two standard logics, logic 1 and logic 0. So if your microcontroller is capable of, IOs are capable of holding these two logics, logic 1 and logic 0. From program, if you are making logic 1, it provides 5 volts with some milliamps current, approximately some 5 milliamps to 10 milliamps max. And logic 0 doesn't provide any voltage, which is 0 volts. But motors have different voltage rating, 12 volts DC motor, 5 volts DC motor, 24 volts DC motor with 100 RPM, 10 RPM, 60 RPM. So these are the different 1000 RPM. These are different RPM rating and with high current, which is 1 amp or 0.5 amps, 2 amps. So this is also the another important parameter. So these kind of different DC motors, how I can interface with microcontroller? That is the main motto here. So once you are aware of the characteristics of your DC motor, you need to search for a suitable driving unit between controller and motor. So what should be the suitable driving unit? How to decide which is a suitable driver unit between microcontroller and motor? So based on these characteristics. So if you are working with simple 5 volts DC motor, the transistor is more enough. The connection should be very clear. I am taking a simple transistor, and that too, the type of transistor is NPN, and the number for this NPN transistor is, which is BC547. So this transistor also used for driving simple DC motor. The specifically I am saying here the characteristics. This is very important. Without knowing your voltage and current rating, you cannot proceed with the transistor or some other driver IC. Okay, so I'm taking now a simple 5 volts DC motor, which is a simple cooling fan from the CPUs or whatever it is. A toy DC motor, which is 5 volts DC motor. The connection should be like this. I'm taking microcontroller. So I'll connect this base of the transistor connected with IO of microcontroller, and you should understand how NPN transistor works. So always your collector and emitter have same type. If you are taking PNP, collector and emitter comes under P type, and if you are dealing with NPN transistor, your collector and emitter deals with N type. So your collector is the output always, and emitter of this transistor is given to ground. And coming to this collector, across collector, what I am taking? I am taking a simple DC motor, and DC motor positive lead is already given to 5 volt source, and negative lead of DC motor given to collector. So what kind of reaction I can expect from the DC motor now, as per my logic of microcontroller IO? So whenever you are making logic 1 for your base, then what is the reaction from the transistor? If you are providing a suitable positive supply across base, because it is a P type, your collector and emitter gets conduction. So whenever your collector and emitter gets conduction, your DC motor, which is already positively, is given to 5 volt source, and negative lead is given to collector. Until unless this collector and emitter is open, so your negative line of DC motor is open, which is float. So neither connected to ground or basis, it is in floating point. But whenever I am giving positive supply across base of the transistor, your collector is conducted with get conduction with ground line, because emitter is already given to ground. So whenever your ground is reaching to DC motor negative line, then it starts clockwise rotation. If suppose I am making logic 0 from the program across IO pin, then your base is not getting any positive supply, which is logic 0 means no voltage across base of the transistor. So this is going to open. So your collector and emitter, which is comes to open state, which is transistor is open. So whenever your transistor is open, the DC motor, which is going to keep off state for logic zero. This is how you can drive a simple DC motor. So I am saying not heavy voltage DC motor, which is simple 5 volts toy DC motor. This is operated with a simple transistor. According to your logic, for logic 1, it is going to rotate clockwise direction, and for logic 0, it is going to off. This is how you can manage your basic simple toy DC motor. Suppose you are looking for 12 volts DC motor like robots. I am trying to drive a robo in different directions by using microcontroller. Whenever you are proceeding for high voltage with high current DC motors, you need to go for the next level switching components from electronics. You need to search these driving capacity devices, which are L293D. So this is another device which will help you to drive your DC motors with high voltages. Like the L293D is one driver IC which is called with different names like H bridge, 4-channel driver, 4-line driver. So this L293D, which will help you to run the DC motors from 5 volts to 24 volts DC, whatever the range. So if you are dealing with 5 volts, or if you are dealing with 12 volts, if you are dealing with 9 volts, if you are dealing with 24 volts, you can use this driver IC to drive the DC motors. And the maximum current rating, which the capability of your L293D driver IC, is up to 2 amps current rating. The voltage driving capacity is 5 volts to 24 volts, and current rating driving capacity is up to 2 amps. So how this L293D driver IC is constructed? So this is another important component from electronics, which is tri-state buffer. I think you may have heard this tri-state buffer from academic. So how this tri-state buffer works? So generally your tri-state buffer contains 3 leads: in input and control and output. So as per L293D, your L293D is constructed with this tri-state buffers, with the integration of more number of tri-state buffers in one IC. The behavior of tri-state buffer is very simple. Whenever I am giving positive supply across this input line, your control and output gets conduction. This is all about the switching. So basically, in electronics, there is no component which will make 5 volts to 10 volts, 5 volts to 15 volts, 5 volts to 24 volts. No. So you need to provide the source of 24 volts or 12 volts. You need to switch that source with the load by using a simple logic or less voltage. That's what the electronic semiconductor's behavior. Okay, so whenever I am giving logic 1 across your input line, logic 1 means the low voltage, it is 5 volts. And whatever the voltage I just connected across this control pin, it may be 12 volts, it may be 9 volts, it may be 24 volts. So which is switched with your output line? So what I am connecting across output lines? So I just proceed with my DC motor. The DC motor positive lead is connected with the output of tri-state buffer, and negative lead is connected with permanent ground. Whenever I am giving logic 1 across input line, so this will help you to switch your control and output. Again, if you are making logic 0 from program, then your control and output will be open state. So as per this, you can notice your DC motor working. If you are making logic 1, your DC motor, it may be 12 volts DC motor, because I just connected 12 volts DC source across control pin. So this 12 volts is forwarded to your DC motor. It starts clockwise rotation for logic 1. And whenever I'm giving logic 0, whenever I'm changing my logic in the program which is 0, then your motor will be off state. So this is what, for logic 0, your motor starts clockwise, which is motor on, and for logic 0, motor off. So this kind of driver units you need to search. Suppose if you are moving for 1000 volts DC motor, which is locomotives or automobiles, so then you need to use relays to drive your voltage by using your programmable logic. So that's what depends on the individual characteristics of motor. You need to go with the different driver units. And L293D is available as integrated circuit, which is as IC. And the L293D pins are, which are 16 pins from this device, which is available as DIP package. And 16 pins are so first pin is enable and second pin is input 1, third pin is output 1 and two ground lines, and sixth pin is output 2, seventh pin is input 2 and VCC. So the VCC is whatever the voltage you are looking to drive for your DC motor, that is the voltage you need to provide across VCC line. And ninth pin is again the same repeated bits this side, enable 2, input 3, output 3 and two ground pins, and output 4, input 4 and VCC. See, you are finding enable, VCC, ground and inputs and outputs. So this tri-state buffer is internally constructed between input and output. So this is how there are four tri-state buffers which are integrated in your L293D driver IC. Across input and output internally there is a tri-state buffer. Whatever the VCC source you are giving here, 12 volts or 24 volts, whatever it is, which is switched with your output 1. And these inputs are given to microcontroller IOs. And outputs are given to motors. This is how you can manage your, you can do your hardware connections with driver IC, with microcontroller and motors. So based on this requirement, you may choose different driver unit. See, for your simple DC motors, you can drive with transistors. For some higher voltages, you need to search for the driver ICs, which is L293D or relays or the other next level driving units, which are DC motors used in different applications. So this is how you can write, you can write one simple embedded C program to rotate your DC motor clock and anti-clockwise directions just by doing the complete connections with driver IC and microcontroller. So you'll proceed with next interfacing in the next session, which is like sensors and stepper motor with some other applications. We are doing multiple application videos. You can follow us on YouTube. Please subscribe our channel, Aerotech Solutions from YouTube. Thanks for watching.